And any good news on the injury front?
Injury front. I think we have bad news with Sini. That obviously he's injured, he's out. Marcos continues out. He hasn't been able to train with the group still. Lloyd Kelly has started training with the group this week. Max Arons is normal. He's available and will be sure in the squad. We continue with Ryan Fredericks out, and we have to recheck the ones who arrived today, and they've come from, especially the ones who started the second game, Meps, Ava, Ryan Christie, Antoine Semenyo. That was still a recovery day for them, and they will train tomorrow, and we will see how they are to take decisions for the weekend.
So Lloyd Kelly not ready.
He's training with the group. He's started training, but it's difficult for me to say today if we have a place in the squad. Probably he has a chance, but it will depend also in other situations.
It's 17 days since between Premier League games off the back of that incredible win over Luton. How have you used the time? Has it come at a good time to have the break, or would you rather have continued?
We cannot change it, so it's always bad when you stop and you are getting the result. I think we were getting the results, but it's true that we've recovered James Hill, we've recovered Max Arons, and Lloyd Kelly is there. We have used these days to train well, but it's true that at the end you have a lot of time to prepare, but with the players probably just tomorrow or just one, two trainings before the actual game, because we have a lot of national team players.
A win like that one over Luton, an incredible comeback. What can that do for the belief of this group going forward?
I think it was a very important game for us, obviously. Before we played, and also considering the situation and the comeback, I think it's very good confidence-wise, but also has to show us that we have a lot of things to improve, because the first half was bad, and we cannot give the advantages we gave against Luton to the next opponents, starting from Everton, no? Because Everton is a team that concedes very few goals, and it will be much more difficult, I think.
How is Dominic Solanke? He's had this knee problem, but he's had a bit of a break now, having not been included with England.
Has been training very well, has been training perfect, no issues. I think has come in a good moment for him personally, this break, and we gave him past week, 1 week, little bit of rest and time for recover, and he has been doing very well this week, and I expect him 100% on the weekend, yes.
I mean, he's going brilliantly this season, but can he use his exclusion from the England setup as motivation going forward?
I said it last week, and I'm pretty sure he's not going to give up. He will try to push and put the pressure on the national team coach and try to make everything he can, because I'm sure it's something important for him. But he's not selfish, you know. He will do the work. He's not only thinking about the goals. He knows that if he gives us the work and he helps us to play better, he will have more chances and he will be closer to the goals.
Do you think Gareth Southgate's missing a trick by not having him in his group?
No, I think it's very difficult, the job of Gareth Southgate. I think he has very, very good players available, and whatever the decision he takes, someone is going to feel like not in the best place. But I think England has top-level strikers. Without even Harry Kane, you can put Ollie Watkins, you can put Ivan Toney, they are very, very good. High-level players, and I think Dom is there and he's playing in at least in this level, yes.
Thank you.
Hi, Andoni. Just in terms of Sinisterra, obviously he's become an important player for you in terms of what you're trying to achieve here. Is there a chance that maybe he has played his last game this season and the focus is now on his recovery?
No, I don't think so. I'm more optimistic. I think it was a clean strain. I think he will be out some weeks, but I see him even after the injury. He came back and feeling like, okay, I will spend my time obviously recovering, but I think he will be available before the end of the season and still will play some games with us. I hope so.
Great. With 10 matches left to go of this season, what's your target now here with Bournemouth?
My target is Everton right now. We have now Everton, the most I can go is this week. We have Everton, Palace, Luton. For us, a very, very important week because also our last games of the season are really difficult against tough opposition, so we have to gain as many points as we can now. And Everton, starting from the next one, for me, I consider a very, very difficult game. Probably is the game we've lost more deservedly from the first lap, let's say.
And in terms of Everton, they haven't won in the league in over 3 months now. You mentioned about them conceding goals. They also don't score many goals. As the manager here, how do you prepare to take them on?
I think it's a very good team. They have very good players. If you look at the stats, the only teams conceding less than them, I think, are the three fighting for the title. And it's true that they are not scoring as many, so they are getting a lot of ties, but they are playing well. I think it's going to be really difficult. They were much better than us in the first game we played there. And I think we have to be at our very best because every goal will be even more important, considering their stats and how they've been playing. And I think we have to start much stronger than we've done last games at home if we want to have a chance, yes.
When you last played them, it was Everton that were winning and you were still looking for a win. The tables have turned now. So what's changed with you and what you're doing with this side?
Different moments, no? Obviously, we have improved. We were probably in the worst moment we've been, no? In the season, and now we are in a much, much better position. But we have to still fight and be in a very good level to try to beat Everton. Otherwise, it's not going to be enough. They are a team that very dangerous in set pieces, very good quality up front, very good players in the middle. I think it's going to be tough duels, and we have to be close to our best to beat Everton, yes.
And just finally from me, it was such an incredible atmosphere here when you beat Luton 4-3. Was it difficult in the following days when all your players disappeared all over the world and you wanted to continue that momentum?
It is, no. I think it was a very, very good moment to have this kind of night, considering the opposition. I think it was an important game for us, also playing at home. But now our focus is to start stronger, no? Because we had a kind of two comebacks against Sheffield United, against Luton, but now I don't think Everton will give us these chances, and we have to start better these games, and obviously always is, but I think first goal will be very, very important.